Buongiorno. Oggi vi presenterò
Hi. Today I present you the Container. This is a single-handed boat with a trapeze, designed in 1967 by Bob Miller, the famous Australian that designed the American's Cup winner Australia 2, using the name of Ben Lexon. This boat, since 1967, is evolved, both in material, setting, boat handling. Today, we will discuss about all these aspects, rigging and sailing the boat. We will see, from the boat to the stern, from the mast to the foil, what, in my opinion, you should choose to rig this boat and make it competitive.
Piede dell'albero e relativa ferramenta.
Mast, step and some hardware around it. In this area are referred almost all trims. In front of the mast we have an elastic rope that keeps in tension the mainsail halyard, which is thin to minimize the windage.
C'è un elastico in questo momento inutilizzato che serve per tenere.
Then there is an elastic band, now unused, which serves to hold the halyard when the sail is hoisted.
Di Cunningham, Base e Vang sono agganciati.
Cunningham, Vang and Foot are fastened to a steel plate which is fixed under the plug for the mast step. This system will allow you to not reel the deck of the boat and prevent any infiltration.
Il piede dell'albero non deve avere.
The mast foot must have any allowance, neither sidewise, neither longitudinal. Also, you may know that this boat has the mast really heeled backward, so you may need to enter under the forward part of the foot a little wedge to step the mast properly.
Una piccola zeppa, in modo tale che l'appoggio sia completo. Eccoci alle principali regole.
Here the principal settings: Vang, Cunningham, and sail foot.
Partiamo dal Vang. Vi consiglio un Vang a leva.
We start from the Vang. I recommend this as a lever Vang, but it's important that the lever, as Giovanni Bonzo teaches to me, has a 3-to-1 ratio, because it is the best possible optimization of the space you have on board. Regarding the pulleys ratio, I recommend you to have a single block on the mast and a double block acting on the lever. This should be sufficient to be able to tension a Vang in strong wind, but the small number of blocks ensure that you have a short rope on board.
Il Vang anche con vento forte. Ma questo piccolo numero di bozzelli vi garantisce di avere poca scotta a bordo. La base.
The foot has a pulley that allows you to split adjustment to the right and the left of the boat. But inside the boom, there is a second pulley that makes a 4-to-1 ratio. The Cunningham will present a pulley around the mainsail and the second block to split the settings on the two different sides of the boat.
La regolazione. La disposizione degli strozzatori è fatta in modo.
The cam cleats are fixed with all different orientation to follow the direction of the ropes. Then you will see that are not parallel.
L'angolo di uscita dal.
Please give particular attention to have a guide in front of the cam cleat, because without this it will be very difficult to stop the rope when you are trapezing. Equally important is to have a guide behind the cam cleat, so when you are trapezing really forward in light wind, it is always possible to stop the sheet.
La regolazione quando vi trovate a trapezio. Ugualmente è importante avere una mascherina a poppa dello strozzatore, in modo tale che quando sarete a trapezio, più a prua o più a poppa della barca, sia sempre possibile posizionare la scotta nello strozzatore. Come attaccare la leva del Vang
al... How to connect the Vang to the boom?
Trattandosi di...
Being a carbon boom, less hole you make, the better it is.
Meglio è. Io ho scelto di optare per questo sistema.
I opted for this system consisting of a row spliced at the ends. In this way, you can spread all the tension that you would load into the Vang fixing point, around the boom itself, until you reach an eyelet fixed with only one steel rivet, and this one also tied the main sheet.
Fino ad arrivare a un occhiello fissato con un solo rivetto di acciaio al boma, e questo solo rivetto tiene anche il paranco della scotta. Questo sistema è molto sicuro.
This system is very safe, and if the rivet is properly fixed, it is without contraindication. But it is very important to use a rope of high quality, and then with a high breaking load and low extension range.
Scendiamo al paranco della randa.
Going down, we find the mainsail pulleys with a 3-to-1 ratio. This system has the great advantage of using a short rope, around 5 meters of length. But it has the drawback of a hard rope to pull in strong wind range.
Avere una scotta molto dura da cazzare con vento forte. La torretta, come potete vedere.
The tower. As you can see, the block is not fixed on the central pivot of the tower itself, but through a shroud plate is brought forward. This system allows the tower to orient itself always correctly, and then it will be always easy to do adjustment when sailing. But there is also an elastic band that passes over the tower and is attached to both sides of the centerboard case. This elastic rope allows a turret to turn more easily too.
È però presente anche un elastico che passa sopra la torretta e si aggancia ad entrambi i lati della scassa di deriva. Questo elastico permette alla torretta di girarsi più facilmente in virata. Parlando invece dell'archetto.
Speaking about the traveler's rope, almost of the contender's sailor prefer a system where a block can run over it, like this. In addition, I recommend, if it is possible, to make your traveler's rope really adjustable, so I advise you to have a cam cleat that allows you to trim the length of it.
Quindi, vi consiglio di avere uno strozzatore.
So, you will trim it long for the light wind condition, or progressively shorter for increasing wind.
Progressivamente più corto per le condizioni di vento teso.
The realization of such system is very simple. The important thing is the deck have the proper wood thickness to fix the cam cleat.
Sia presente lo spessore di legno sufficiente a fissare. Antisdrucciolo.
This is the pro grip, the surface that allows you to not slide on the deck while you are trapezing. Here there are some tricks. This portion on the transom, which wraps the corner, will help you to sail the boat safely and stably even in strong wind, when you need to move extremely back. This idea comes from Giovanni Bonsio.
Molto teso. Idea di Giovanni. Vi consiglio di coprire tutto lo specchio di poppa.
I recommend you to cover all the aft deck with the pro grip, because when you sail, you can move everywhere without losing the friction. Reaching your boat becomes almost a surfboard.
Questa superficie non si tocca quasi mai con i piedi.
This surface is almost never touched by your feet. But the few times that you need to grip the foot in here, a good friction will save you from a capsize.
Vi salveranno da una scuffia se riuscite ad avere un buon attrito su questa faccia del pozzetto. Con poco vento.
In light wind it could be useful to not slip with your feet over the center bow case. So it's better if you cover with a pro grip this area too.
Potreste avere le punte dei piedi appoggiate lì. Quando invece navigate a trapezio,
when sailing on trapeze, maybe high on it, it is possible that your feet don't step only over the gunwale, but it's possible that your toes are well over the deck. So I suggest you to cover the entire surface of this area and you can move your feet without losing stability.
Coprire tutta la superficie della coperta in quest'area, in modo tale che voi possiate spostare i vostri piedi senza mai perdere di stabilità. L'area di prua, a prua dell'archetto.
The surface for then the traveler used when sailing in downwind and light wind is the area where the pro grip is less useful.
Ed è la zona dove il pro grip, cioè l'antisdrucciolo, ha meno utilità.